Here are some local corporate headlines. Philippine Airlines partners with the Expedia Group to launch a one-stop travel site, PAL Holidays. This platform connects flyers to all their travel needs, including PAL flights, hotels, and travel activities. PAL Holidays is now available in the Philippines, the US, Canada, and Australia. Meanwhile, telco giant Globe will launch its prepaid eSIMs this month. This shift means subscribers no longer need to go to physical stores or wait for SIM card deliveries. The eSIMs will be exclusively available in the telco's Globe One mobile app. AgriNurture completes its reacquisition of Freshness First, an Australian firm engaged in the business of trading fresh and processed fruits in the state of Queensland. AgriNurture's unit in Hong Kong first sold all its interest in Freshness First for $2.5 million back in 2015. And finally, Repower Energy Development to incorporate first-tier subsidiary Baguio Asin Hydropower to operate its hydropower projects.
Several agriculture groups calling for the resignation of the Philippine finance chief and the country's top economist over their rice tariff policies. But Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno insists his agency only supports policies that are for the greatest good. We have more from Andrea Taguines.
Recent floods have wiped out Iyahamandres rice field in the town of Camiling in Tarlac Province. She has yet to recover from the impact of the storms, but she's fearing the proposed tariff reduction on rice imports. While it's meant to lower the price of rice in the market, Iya says it will also further bring down the farm gate price of palay to the detriment of farmers. Iya joined other farmers from other provinces in Metro Manila on Monday to protest the policy.
17 na po yung kuha po ng mga traders sa amin. Paano na lang kaya pagkasagsagan na po ng anihan? Baka bababa pa po sa 17. Paano pa po kami makakabangon sa presyo na yon?
Apart from its impact on farm gate prices, farmers fear removing import tariffs on rice will also take away from the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund, or RCEF, a fund meant to help farmers remain competitive amid the entry of rice imports.
Kasi, di ba, yung kita doon sa taripa, yun ang ginagamit sa RCEP na binibigay sa amin mga farmers, pati Farm Mechanization Program, mawawala na yan lahat.
From Quezon City to Manila, farmers groups marched to the offices of several government agencies and groups who are in favor of lowering or cutting the import tariffs on rice to voice their opposition. Their last stop here at the Department of Finance headquarters, where they also called for the removal from office of DOF Secretary Benjamin Diokno and NEDA Director General Arsenio Balisacan for proposing the policy in the first place.
In a statement, Diokno said Malacañang is still discussing the proposal. But he stood his ground, saying it's the appropriate policy response that promotes the greatest good for the greatest number of Filipinos. He also assured local farmers the government will continue to pursue measures that would balance their interests while keeping rice affordable for consumers. In line with this, the National Food Authority, which is chaired by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., has agreed to raise the maximum buying rate for palay. Marcos announced that the NFA will now buy dry palay for 19 pesos to 23 pesos per kilo, while wet palay will be bought for 16 to 19 pesos per kilo.
Ang production cost naman ng mga farmer ngayon mas nasa 14-15. So meron na silang pagkikitaan. At bukod pa ron, nandiyan na yung price cap. So para maikalma natin itong nangyayari sa rice price.
Agricultural group Sinag welcomed this development, but it said Marcos should ensure that it will be properly implemented. The Department of Agriculture, for its part, said it would support the NFA proposal but at a level of 23 pesos a kilo. The agency added that farmers are satisfied with 23 pesos since they are now being paid 16 to 19 pesos per kilo. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Asian markets kicked off the week on a sour note ahead of the central bank decisions. Trading volumes were also muted, with Japanese markets closed for a holiday. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led declines, roiled up once again by the property sector. Shares of the world's most indebted property developer, China Evergrande, plunged as much as 25% on Monday trade. That's after news that police detained some staff at its wealth management unit, suggesting at a new investigation that could add to the company's troubles. In other stock movements, shares of Asian chipmaker slide after Taiwan's TSMC, the world's top chipmaker, asked vendors last Friday to delay deliveries amid concerns over slowing demand. Here at home, the local market opened the week flat as traders also prepare for the Philippine Central Bank's decision.
Given how inflationary pressures are looking right now, we're still seeing potential downside below 6,000 towards 4,800. With this, it would be ideal to accumulate, but in tranches, so as to mitigate that potential downside. But for those long-term investors, I think there's a lot of value that we can extract now by positioning for the long run.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of several oil giants after they were sued by the state of California, accusing them of playing down the risks posed by fossil fuels. The lawsuit targets ExxonMobil, Shell, Chevron, BP, and ConocoPhillips. Also in focus, shares of Societe Generale, France's third largest listed bank. That's after its new CEO, who took over in May, cut profitability targets and forecast lower growth. Shares of the French bank are down over 9% in midday trading. We're also keeping a close watch on Lonza, which announced its CEO would be leaving by the end of the month. The news sent shares of the Swiss drug manufacturer plunging 9%. The Philippine Supreme Court asked to declare the Maharlika Investment Fund unconstitutional. Former Bayan Muna Party List representatives Nery Colmenares, Carlos Zarate, and Ferdinand Gaite filed a petition for certiorari and prohibition. They are joined as petitioners by Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel. The petitioners argued that there was no public calamity or public emergency when President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. certified the bill as urgent. They add, the law is a disaster waiting to happen because it did not go through test of economic viability.
During this time that there's a worldwide, in fact, recession, no? Yung ibang malalaking bansa nga ay ingat na ingat sila, no? Pero ito ang Pilipinas, tayo gumawa tayo ng ganitong pondo, niligay sa isang korporasyon na napaka hindi sigurado yung accountability.
Vinilate din yung constitutional requirement na independent dapat ang Bangko Sentral. Ang Maharlika ay hindi independent sa Malacanang. At maaring gamitin ang pondo nito sa corruption o cronyism.